Hey everyone, it's Ruth from CORE. I am coming back with our review of the Pilates exercises that you can do on Joseph Pilates' original equipment. This chair is actually a version of the original chair, the Wunda chair. So it serves the same purpose, and it's basically the same design, just slightly changed. But it works the same as his original chair, and we do have a couple of his original chairs here in the studio that can do all kinds of things because they have poles attached to them, so you can use them for all kinds of upper body work too. Anyway, so the chair was created as a way for everybody in America to have a piece of exercise equipment in their home, because you'd have to imagine it, but if you flipped it this way, the back of the chair would come up, and that would be like a chair in your living room. And so you could put a sofa cushion there, and when you're ready to exercise, you take off the cushion, you flip it, put on the springs, because this is all spring-loaded, just like our reformer, and then you can get to work. So that's one of the reasons it was created. And so I wanted to show you a few things that you can do on the chair and how it kind of differs a little bit from reformer. It differs a lot, obviously, because it's smaller, but there are some similar things that you can do, and all the Pilates equipment work, you can, and even the mat work, you can do some of the same movements, like swan can be done on the reformer, it can be done on the chair, it can be done on the mat. So there's lots of things that you can do, and I'm sorry, I gotta close something on my screen there. Okay, anyway, so if we start off with some simple things like footwork, and you know, I say simple because there's not a lot of movement involved. However, the goal with this is to keep your pelvis still as you're moving your legs. And a lot of times, you know, if we don't really pay attention to our core and keep that engaged, as we're pushing our legs down, sorry, I gave a little too much power there, the pelvis moves around. So our goal is to challenge our core to be able to maintain that neutral position of the pelvis as we're pumping our legs. We can do different foot positions, work on a little bit of calf work. You can do single leg. So if we do single leg, it's gonna be a little more challenging, and then I have to keep this other leg engaged as I'm doing it. We can take our legs into a wider position. And all of this is going to challenge the legs for sure. Like, you're gonna get a little work here. And right now I don't have real heavy spring on there, but we can go heavier and heavier with the spring to make the leg work a little more challenging and to challenge our core so the pelvis doesn't move. So then we can also do some standing leg work. So if I was to stand, and this is where, if you have the original Wunda chair with our rails coming up, you can actually support yourself and have a little more balance, okay? So you don't have to do it freestanding like I'm gonna show you, but there's gonna be one foot coming up, and of course we always look to make sure our toes aren't too close, we wanna be careful and safe, and then pumping this leg, but maintaining not just your balance and your stability, but your hips, and making sure that they're staying nice and neutral as well. So we're working on a lot of different things while we're doing our single leg pumping. You can do some other simple things that will help to stretch the spine, but also work your obliques. So if I bring my hand onto the pedal for a little kind of a modified mermaid position, this leg can extend out so I can get even some stretch down here through the hip as I bring this over, okay? And then, you know, we can modify this to also challenge ourselves a little bit more with the legs, and we can come into that same position. And there's a lot of different exercises that you can do on the floor, and put your feet on the chair or put your hands on the chair. I'm not gonna show you those today just because I only have so much time, and I wanted to show you some of the exercises that we probably use the most. Then we can do some assisted back extension. Now, you won't probably be able to see my legs as well when we're doing this particular one, but this is a swan on the chair, basically. So we have a little bit of support from our pedal now, so that when we come up into our extension, we can really work on that thoracic extension right through this mid-back area. And we can even work the glutes as we fire up and bring those legs up to bring the pedal down. So that is a great way to get the backside, the whole extension happening. I have to get closer to the screen. Oh, hi, Nicole. Hey, Nicole is from Texas. That's my study buddy from Polestar. Hi, Nicole. So those are some of the basic things we can do. Now, I'm going to add a little bit of spring on here, and then I'll show you how we can do some core, a little bit more intense exercise, working on the core, stretching the legs, and then also working on the legs. So I push the pedal all the way down, I bring my hands forward, and now I have to work on this to bring that pedal up. So there is a little bit of leverage and there's a little bit of, you know, spring help, obviously, but we're working from our center. And notice I had to be quiet because I had to really use my breath as a tool to get those abdominals firing up to be able to lift that pedal up. There's also, we can do a lunge or taking our foot on top of the chair, and then we're gonna get a little help from the spring, but I definitely have to work on this leg to get myself up. And again, I'm working on balance, so I'm probably not gonna look at the camera, I gotta look over here. But we would normally have our rails up so that you can have a little bit of support and balance there as well. So we're gonna bring it up into our lunge position. So now I'm definitely working on my legs, but I'm also trying to make sure that my pelvis stays nice and still, okay? So that's just, you know, a few exercises that you can do on the chair. There's so many more. There's so many things you can do on the reformer, the chair, the tower. So when I come back next week, I'm going to show you some tower work. And then from there, we'll be going to the ladder barrel. I mean, there's so many different pieces of equipment that we can use for Pilates. So I hope you all enjoyed just getting a little bit of an example of what the chair is capable of. I didn't give you enough. I probably should show you more, but because of our time factor, I can't show you a whole bunch. So thanks so much for watching. And Nicole, I'm so glad you tuned in. And I'll see you all next week. Bye.